Today we're going to be doing a review on this 300 gallon reef tank behind me. The changes on the equipment, changes on the livestock, what's going right and what's going wrong, coming up. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Real Reefing TV, where I help you save time, money, and frustration in the real reefing hobby, sharing my experiences and knowledge. And today, we're going to be discussing this 300-gallon reef tank and what changes I've made to the equipment, the livestock, what's going right and what's going wrong. Give you a little bit of a pulse check on how this thing's doing. Now, if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, consider doing so. There's new videos coming out each and every week. I deliver content to you guys to help you save that time, save that money, and keep you from pulling your hair out. Now, if you've already liked my Facebook page, perfect, you're part of the club. If you haven't, drop down to the comments section after the video and go over to my Facebook page. Give it a like, so that way, going forward, you'll be getting up-to-date, current content, what's going on, sneak peeks, and even some more information and tips on that page, so go check it out. Now today is all about this 300 gallon reef tank, and I wanted to go through some of the changes on the tank. Now as far as equipment goes, I'm still running the same lights. For flow, I have changed that up a bit. Now you know that I've switched over to Rossmonts, and I put the Rossmont movers and waver, which is the controller for the movers, on this tank. I've got four of them. I've got two MX4100s and two MX3500s. That's 3,500 gallons an hour each and 4,100 gallons an hour each on this tank. 4,100 gallons on each side, and then on the back, I've got two of the 3,500s. So 3,500 gallons an hour pumping through the back. Now those are fully controllable and I'm doing that. So I did decide to go ahead and take off the MP40s. I wasn't using them. They were just sitting there looking pretty. They do look nice, albeit, but I think that this is a solution that I want to promote because they do offer something for the reefer that doesn't have the money to throw down on some MP40s. But don't get me wrong, I love the MP40s. One other change that I've made to the flow in this tank is I've also added my Ice Cap Gyre 1K. So it was just way too powerful for my 10-gallon Anno, so I went ahead and threw it in here. Gives me a nice different flow pattern in the tank, and it fits nicely over here on the side. You can't even hardly see it. It's black, blends in with the sidewall. It's great. I think it adds a lot of good flow over the top of that big green Passiflora in the back. Now, another equipment change that I made on this tank is actually down in the filtration level down below, and that's for my biopellet reactor. So this is the biopellet reactor that I was using before. It's the Cadlite's conical biopellet reactor. It's got a small pump in here, and it was doing the trick for quite some time. Had this on the tank for about 2 years, and I figured that it was just time for a change. I really couldn't add very many biopellets to this just because of the way that I had to run it. This pump down below would tumble the biopellets inside, and then the biopellets couldn't really reach the top because they lost too much flow up in this upper region here, and they would fall back down, and that's what would create the tumble. So they would tumble inside, and then the water would flow off the edge. And that worked well, but I just wasn't able to add the biopellets that I needed to be able to solve some issues for this tank, and I'll get into that here in just a minute, and that's kind of what's been going wrong, but now kind of going right. So at any rate, this needed to be replaced, and I wanted something that, for my followers out there that are looking for something that's gonna help save them some money to be able to do that. Now, I think that the difference between a very expensive biopellet reactor and a less expensive biopellet reactor, I think the difference in between what you pay in addition, I don't think that there is a commensurate value always. Now, sometimes there might be, and I might be missing it, but I don't think that that's always the case. And I think that if you can find something that is less expensive but provides you 75% of the features and quality that you would get with something that is twice as expensive, I think that that is something that's worth investing in. I think it's worth utilizing, unless you just have the cash flow to throw at it. So anyways, I went on Amazon and searched for a biopellet reactor that that had decent quality in the reviews. I read all the reviews, but also had, you know, the capacity that I needed for this tank. Now, this is a 300-gallon tank, but it's not all about the size of the tank. It's about what you have in it and the bioload that's in there. And I knew how many mLs of biopellets that I'm using, and this one fit the bill. So it's a 1-liter biopellet reactor, and it's been doing a great job. It's tumbling great. Now, some of the reviews on it say that the pump is too powerful. And yes, if you crank it all the way down, yes, it absolutely is, but there's ways to fine-tune and adjust the flow. So in the future, I'm gonna be making a video about that biopellet reactor and doing a review on it. Now, this is something that I purchased myself with my own $60, so, you know, it's going to be as real as it gets. Okay, so one thing that I think is really cool and I'm excited to share with you guys is this awesome, nifty little gadget. It's a tube holder for dosing. And so if you have a doser, this is an absolute must have so that you don't have your tubes falling out of your sump and causing a huge mess. Now, this tube holder holds 4 tubes, and it looks way better than any one that I've ever seen on the market. Currently, I have an eShops one, and this just blows it away aesthetically. And does a great job holding it with 3 points of contact and no thumb screws. So it's a really awesome little piece. It is 3D printed, and they have all different sizes. I'll throw the link in the description below so that you guys can go check those out and pick one up if it's something that fits your needs. Let's talk about livestock. So in this tank, if you've watched some of my earlier videos, go back and watch the video on livestock up here. That was one of my first videos that I did talking about the livestock in this tank. And there was this huge, huge frog spawn, about the size of a volleyball. And I'm not even kidding you when I say it was this big. It was absolutely massive, had over 100 heads. Well, I decided after long deliberation to go ahead and rehome him. I traded him in to the coral store for $200 worth of credit, which I'm sure he was worth more than that. That's why the store took him. Now, the reason why I decided to get rid of him is because it was mostly brown, had some green in there. Of course, brown corals need love too. I get it. Just not in my tank. I want as much color as I can. And plus, I'm making the shift from less LPS to more SPS. And I do like zoas. I've been getting into those a little bit as well. So I did trade him in for some really nice zoas and palis. I got some Utter Chaos. I got some Pink Zippers, some Gatorade zoas. And it's just been really nice having those new corals, and I'm seeing them start to encrust already. I've also moved some other corals around. You'll see some plates that were in a spot and they're no longer there. They're in a different spot. I moved my big bird's nest from on this side to over here just to fill in some gaps, open things up. There were some corals that were fighting, and so I think I really like the new layout much better now, and it gives me more spots to add corals. I got some new acans, I got some new SPS, and so all of those are just having a new spot to thrive and grow and fill in those rocks. I don't want to see any more rock, I just want to see coral. So another big livestock change, and if you've been watching this show religiously, then you know I have a pure hatred for my 6-line RAS. Great, yeah, I mean, just great coloration, but he's a total jerk. Any new fish that I put in here, he'll pick on them relentlessly, and if they're not strong enough to survive the first few days, they're gonna be dead. Because he's gonna pick on them, he's gonna run them around the tank, he's gonna stress them out, they won't eat, and then they'll die. So, I said, you know what, that's it, I'm done with you, I'm gonna try to trap you again. And so I threw my big trap in there, and nothing. And so I thought, you know what, let me do a quick YouTube search. And I searched up some videos and people were trapping them using the bottle trap method. And if you're not sure what that is, it's basically where you have a plastic bottle and you cut the top off, you invert the top, stick it down in, glue it so that the fish can swim in through the cap, in through the top of the bottle basically, and then they get stuck on the inside of it. Similar to any other type of trap, but you're using a plastic. And then what you do is you bait it with some type of bait. So I did that, and within 24 hours, I had him. It was great, and he's down below. So he's out, and now I get to start shopping for some new fish. I'm really excited. I really love to add some new wrasses, like a leopard wrass or some flasher wrasses and things like that. Get your mind out of the gutter. Now, this isn't an equipment change, but it is something that I've started utilizing again that I wasn't utilizing before. And that's my J-Bow doser. So I do have that back online and it's working again. I figured out what was wrong with it and why it wasn't working. And why it wasn't working is because I was using these little like RO bulkhead things for my dosing reservoirs. And for some reason, those were creating an air gap in them and they just weren't working efficiently anymore. So it was letting air in and that doser couldn't actually suck or vacuum that water out, or liquid, I should say, out of the dosing container. So anyways, I went ahead and bypassed those and just used the silicone tubing, airline tubing, and that's been working great. I am dosing Acro Power and alkalinity and calcium solution to the tank. Right now, I'm dosing that part A and part B because my calcium reactor had a little bit of an issue. I'm also dosing Kalkwasser as well in my auto top off, and that's helping me to get those elements elevated to where they need to be. Now, quick tip for you, you don't want to elevate your alkalinity any more than a quarter DKH a day, and you don't want to, obviously less than that if you're raising it. If you can do it slower than that, that would be ideal, but you also don't want to elevate your calcium any more than 50 parts per million a day. I would like to see it a little bit lower than that. So I've been trying to go about it about 10 to 15 parts per million on the calcium a day, raising that until I get it to where I want it to be. Then I'm gonna start to dial up my calcium reactor, dial back down on the dosing and the Kalkwasser. I'll do one at a time. That way I can really monitor the changes and what's going on with the calcium and alkalinity in the tank. I have seen more growth as I've started to do this, so I'm really excited about that. And all the corals, the new corals that I've gotten are encrusting already, and it's only been a matter of a couple of weeks. So one thing that's gonna be coming up pretty soon that I'm working on is a way to test this light up here. So I have it, well, you can't really see it very well. I'll give you a shot of it right now. But this light is was also sent to me from Luxbird, and it's a reef light. It's full spectrum. It has cool whites, warm whites, blues, ultraviolets, reds, and greens in there. So it is a full spectrum light. It is on the less expensive scale when it comes to lights, so I wanted to test it out for you guys. I thought that that might be really nice to see another type of Chinese black box if you're not willing or if you're not able to drop the dough on some radions or some aqua illumination lights and you just want a light that's going to be able to work for you. Don't run out and buy it just yet. I want to review it for you guys and really give it a test. So my plan is to either tie in a 10-gallon tank down below and run a sample on it. I want to take some corals from up here underneath my radions and put them down below in a separate 10-gallon tank that's only being lit by that light. So it will have the exact same parameters in water chemistry. So that will all be exactly the same. The bacteria, everything will be exactly the same. The only difference will be the light. I think it's pretty inexpensive. I think it's like $100 for this light. It'll cover a 2x2 area. But like I said, don't run out and buy it just yet. I will throw a link so you can see it. But let me do a review on it for you guys so that you can tell if it's something that you like. And so for that reason, make sure that you follow along with this channel so that you can see that review coming up. Now, what's not going so well? Well, my red slime came back, but now it's receding back again. When I got that new biopellet reactor, I added more biopellets and it's taken some time, but now they're starting to get going and I'm seeing that red slime algae start to die back down. And it's almost gone off the sand bed. It was a very thick mat of just red, nasty, I may have been a little bit embarrassed about it, so that's maybe why you haven't seen too much of the 300 lately, but now it's starting to get cleared up, and I'm glad to see that happen. So it just goes to show, don't stop, don't give up, keep moving forward, figure out what the issue is, and move on with it, and just keep plugging along. You know, there's a phrase in Japanese, but it's called Kaizen. That's the word in Japanese, and it means continuous improvement. And that's the motto that I live by professionally, personally and also in this hobby, continuously improve. And if you continue to do that, if you can live by that, continuously improve, Kaizen your reef tank, then you're going to see a better reef tank next year than you will have this year and the year after that. So don't give up. Keep moving forward. Kaizen your reef, and you're going to have a successful reef tank. That's it for the update on this one. Hit that button right there to subscribe to this channel if you haven't done it already. Drop down in the comments below and let me know what's going on with your reef tank. Are you having success? Are you struggling a little bit? And in what ways can you improve your reef tank? Go check me out on Facebook. And if you're into it, check out this video right over here. I'm out. Peace.